There is something very important about these past years, is data. We humans became collectors of data, Fitbits, GPSs, pictures. Look how much credit card purchases, how much data is around.
Certain machine learning algorithms really thrive on big data, as long as computers have the processing power to handle it, which they do now. If computers are the cannon and the internet is gunpowder, these are the fireworks, and they have only just begun. In his book, Pedro Domingos offers a nice, simple way of understanding supervised machine learning. He says every algorithm has an input and an output. The data goes into the computer, the algorithm does what it will with it, and out comes the result. Machine learning turns this around. In goes the data and the desired result, and out comes the algorithm that turns one into the other. The algorithms are trained to find statistical relationships in the data that allow it to make good guesses when presented with new examples. That means we no longer have an easy rule for what kinds of tasks computers can and cannot do.
These days, we spend a lot of time looking at screens. Computers, smartphones, and televisions are a big part of our lives. They're how we get most of our news, use social media, watch movies, and more. Virtual reality and augmented reality are two technologies changing the way we use screens, creating new and exciting interactive experiences. Virtual reality, also known as VR, uses a headset with a built-in screen that displays a virtual environment for you to explore. These headsets use a technology called head tracking, which allows you to look around the environment by simply moving your head. Augmented reality, or AR, is a bit different. Instead of transporting you to a virtual world, it takes digital images and layers them on the real world around you. This is done through the use of either a clear visor or a smartphone. So with VR, you could explore a world full of dinosaurs. But with AR, you could see those dinosaurs moving through the world around you. Both of these technologies are growing at a rapid pace and being implemented in a variety of different ways. Surgeons are using VR to practice highly technical surgeries before operating. Businesses are using them to give consumers virtual tours of products and locations. There are even apps that can use your smartphone's camera to scan and translate a foreign language in real time. As they continue to grow, VR and AR have the potential to greatly change almost every industry. You'll want to keep an eye on them to see how they might soon affect your job and potentially your everyday life.